throw that word in the microwave, put it on the stove, slang it in the oven, man, however you want to go, chop it up, cook it up, man. Welcome back to another episode. In the first episode of the year, I just want to thank all of my subscribers that have been with me. If you're not a subscriber, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, press the like button, because we're going to do this thing on YouTube, shadow banning or not. You can't stop the truth of God no matter what, no matter how much control you have, you cannot stop the power and the message of God. So do that for me. As y'all can tell, it's early in the morning. I got my coffee. Been drinking coffee for a long time, so you know I love it ever since a kid. But it's a new year. I'm about to have a new birthday coming up this Thursday, January 6th. All my cap babies turn up. I know, you know what I'm saying, I teach the Bible, and all my doctrine is based on scripture. And yes, I do represent Capricorn. Some people don't agree, but it is what it is, you know. God is not scared to be questioned. And I was raised to always look and see where you can find information and, you know, truth. Jesus is the ultimate truth, but God and Christ is revealed in everything, everything that we do. Even if someone is say it's evil, it's witchcraft, you know, first of all, whatever the witchcraft is, it was made by God to begin with. It was just something that the devil took and twisted. Plain and simple. The devil is not a creator, so he can't make a god, he can't make an idol. He has to take something that God has already made and turn it into something that we bow down and worship. And I don't worship the stars. I don't worship, you know, whatever they feel like that the zodiac come from, but I'm me. I'm covered in the blood, and we ain't gonna get into all that. But my reason for making this video is I'm tired of black people being ignorant. Because our culture, everything is funny. Everything is a joke. We get a laugh. We don't take nothing serious until we the ones looking stupid in the end. And this morning I was scrolling on Facebook, you know, not Facebook, Instagram. Come across this post, it's a video of Paris Stone, and this video has been out. It first started with Kev online cracking jokes about it, and I was upset then. I did a video back then, but the video was, you know, Paris Stone explaining the whole situation because it's not right. If you don't know about something, especially dealing with God, you don't play with it. You don't put your mouth on something that you don't know nothing about. And what people don't understand is that there is in scripture where God says, you cannot be forgiven for blasphemy of the Holy Spirit. That means calling God's spirit that's in action, that's in motion, that's moving, evil or the devil. Associating God's spirit with evil or the devil. And the Pharisees even did it to Jesus. They said that Jesus was the prince of demons. That's how he can cast out demons. And why we don't know this? Because we don't read. Those of us who claim to be Christians, we go to church, we want the pastor to teach us to do everything. We want the pastor to preach, teach, marry, bury, clean the church, you know what I'm saying, do the hospital visits, and go out there and win the loss for us. But that's not That's not the job of the pastor. The pastor is to raise you up to go out there and do those things. And it says that in the Bible, you know, that the pastor is there. The fivefold ministry is there to equip the saints to do the work of the ministry. How can you argue with that? But back to the Perry Stone situation is they want to go off of this video where they were having a prayer service. Perry Stone was speaking in tongues. And yes, tongues is real if you read the Bible. No, tongues didn't go away with the apostles. The baptism of the Holy Spirit still happens this very day. Myself, I experienced the baptism of the Holy Spirit last year in a hotel room. And I'm talking about just a refreshing and a cleansing and a power that descended on me in that room. And an understanding that I didn't have before. And that's after 14 years of study, theological training, preaching, teaching, and believing. And I was finally baptized with the Holy Spirit after almost dying from COVID, from the Delta variant. It almost took me out, and it put me in a place where I had to go back and just reflect and rethink life and rethink everything that I wasn't doing right, everything that I wasn't doing at all. And it opened me up to have that infilling of the power and presence of God. So with this video being mocked this morning, it stirred up something in my spirit again, because people are on there in the comments, this is the devil, this is fake, this is why black people leaving the church. You know, black people leaving the church because black people don't like to be told nothing. Black people leave the church because black people don't read the Bible. And then when the pastor mess up, they just give up on everything. But the main thing is, we are all human. But another thing is, if you were searching and researching behind everything he was saying, you would have saw that he was for the fall before he fell. You could have maybe helped catch him. But nah, you doing your own thing. You probably not even listening while he preaching. So we got to stop being ignorant. Pick up the Bible and read it. And I'm so tired of people saying, you know, you're not supposed to be doing that. You're supposed to be a Christian. Church not supposed to be doing that. How you know? How do you know what a Christian not supposed to do, what the church not supposed to do, or what they, you don't know nothing. Is that in the Bible? I mean, the greatest statement I've ever heard is, if you want to hide something from black people, you hide it in the book. And that's true. And it's sad. But we are so quick to judge and point our fingers at people and tear somebody down and make jokes. We great at making jokes. I mean, we can blow somebody down and jokes all day. But when we gonna start teaching? We can't teach because we don't know. And then we pass that on to our kids, and then our kids don't know nothing. And what I don't like is we have two mechanisms, and I guess, you know, these are safety mechanisms for us because we've been through so much as a people. We either, if we can't defend something, we get mad, and then we turn into a bully to make people leave us alone. or we turn it into a joke so we can laugh about it so we don't have to take it serious. Why? Why do we have to fight? And why does everything have to be a joke? Why can't we logically cancel things out, defend ourselves with words of knowledge, words of love, words from the Holy Scripture, instead of telling somebody we'll beat them up to shut them down or hee hee ha ha our way out of a situation? We do too much and we don't do enough. But we swear we know everything. It's time for us to get ourselves together. And the only way you can become a new person is to renew your mind. If you don't believe in the Bible, read the Bible to disprove it. If, you know, read. That's all you gotta do. Read. Read, study, research. If you're a believer and you love the word, and you want to know what's the difference between Christianity and Islam, read the Quran. You know, you can't be afraid to study. Because if you are grounded in what you know, nothing can persuade you. Nothing can take you off of the foundation that you have built. Whether it's Christianity, Islam, Mormonism, Buddhism, whatever. If you're solid in what you believe on, you're not going to move. Me, I'm solid on the Bible. I'm solid on Jesus being God. Right there, yeah. Jesus being God. Where did I say that at? It's in the Bible. But the Bible say Jesus is the Son of God. Yeah. But Jesus is also God. We get so many things mixed up because we don't study. So this year, I'm going to help you. If you want to be helped, roll with me. I don't know everything. If I don't know it, I'm going to find out. That's been me. That's my way of life. If I don't know something, I'm going to ask. I'm going to find out. The thing is, if I ask and it don't sound right, I'm going to find out. Ain't nobody for to tell me nothing. And I just run with it. I wasn't raised like that. When I got saved, I stopped saying words like amen, hallelujah, till I read and understood what they meant. Because I'm not built like that. You got to show me. You say, do what? Oh, where they say that at? Right? Okay, all right, yeah. Then, okay. That's how we need to be. Just because it sounds good and the person is passionate about what they're talking about, don't mean they know what they're talking about and don't mean that it's right. So, oh, man, look. So back to what I was saying with Perry Stone. This man of God was having a prayer service, speaking in the spirit, praying in tongues. Then he was on his phone and started to groan. To make a long story short, he was on the phone taking prayer requests. He stopped speaking in tongues and then started a groan. The Bible tells us in Romans that the spirit in us, sometimes we may not have the words to speak, but the spirit groans from within us. And the one who gave us the Spirit knows the heart of the Spirit, because the Spirit is Him. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. One God. Spirit is God, Son is God, the Father is God. Together, one. You have a mind, you have a soul, you have a spirit. You are a three-dimensional being, but you are still one. The groan that comes from His Spirit connected with our spirit, because we may not know what to pray, but God the Father knows the heart of the Spirit that He has put in us, and that He has created for us, knows what the Spirit is trying to communicate and moves on our behalf. So there is a heavenly language speaking in tongues, and there are groans from the Spirit that God understands. Read your Bible. Romans 8, 26, 27, just in case y'all think I'm tripping. In the same way, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us through wordless groans. And He who searches our hearts knows the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. Boom, drop the mic. I would drop my phone, but I'll be stupid. So with that said, y'all, let's get our minds together. Let's renew our minds. The only way you can renew your mind is read the Bible. The Bible tells us, renew your mind. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Be metamorphed, be transformed. Become something new. Become something better. Become what God has intended for you to become by renewing your mind by His Word. And I don't want to drag this video on any longer, so y'all come back for the next one. Peace. And I love you.